All right, come on, milk can. I'm gonna call you that from now on because that's exactly what you are. What the fuck are you looking at? He's just looking at the rocks. He's an interesting one. What's going on, guys? Dragast here, and welcome. We're going to be checking out Yonder the Cloudcatcher Chronicles today. And this game, I was actually lucky enough to check out in 2016 at PAX, and it was one of my favorite games there. It is absolutely beautiful. I didn't really check out too much of it, but it's an open-world RPG with a very cartoony art style, almost like Wind Waker HD, if you do like that game. So we're going to be checking out this game today. It's just going to be a first impression, and if you guys like it, let me know in the comments below. Maybe we'll do some more, maybe we won't. Alright, but first of all, we gotta make our character. So, it's a very basic character creator right now. We can either have some junk in the trunk or some junk in the chest. I'm gonna go with the trunk. And then, of course, body size. Now, is that height or no? It's actually, I gotta be huge or skinny. I'm gonna go on the big side. We're gonna be a big, beefy dude. Wait, what does the female look like? Do we have any different options for her? No. Okay, so it's just one hairstyle, unfortunately. I wonder if you can buy more in-game or something. Well, I'm happy with that. I got brown hair and brown eyes, so I'm gonna keep this guy kind of similar as well, and let's get into it. So, let's watch the cutscene. Our dearest child, it broke our hearts when we sent you away, but it was the only way to keep you safe from the darkness that poisoned our land. When the day comes that you seek the truth, trust in this celestial compass to guide you. Now, there's a compass in this game that kind of helps you in quests and whatnot. It will lead you far across the sea, into the darkness, and into the light, but it will always lead you home. Home is Gemma. Okay, and here we go to Gemma. Or, okay, a ship. Never mind. We're making our way to Gemma on the ship. So this is a really beautiful starting cutscene here. This was not in the original version of the game that I checked out, I believe. I think you just started off in a cave, if I remember correctly. But here's our little dude with his celestial compass. All right, so it looks like Gemma's right over there. Let's go talk to Jib the Sailor. That's a weird name for a lady, but okay. This is amazing. I thought Gemma was just a made-up tale. I'm glad I came from the kitchen to see this. Okay, that's a little bit sexist, game. I'm gonna be honest. I mean, of all the places, you choose kitchen. Okay, well, I'm glad you're out of the kitchen, Jib. All right, so I guess we just gotta talk to people right now, and I'm assuming something will happen when we talk to them all. Looks like your compass is pointing into the bank of the fog. Looks pretty thick. I'd best get up to the bell. So yes, I guess I'm leading the ship with my compass right now. I didn't know I had all this power. All right, Tack the Sailor. You guys got some weird-ass names. Tack looks way too much like me. It's fucking weird. That is the definition of me. Tack, you really are me, except you got blue eyes. So the legend is true. There really is an island kingdom. I wonder if we'll see any strange new creatures. I know we will, because I was lucky enough to check out this game. And Captain Pullen. What you pulling, buddy? All right, if the compass of yours is right, Gemma should be just behind that bank of fog. Are you ready to finally see the island? Yes, I am. What are you gonna say? No, I just want to live on this ship. Of course I want to see it. All right, and there it is. Okay, it's actually a lot bigger than I thought. So I wonder if this is the real scale of the island, because that looks pretty interesting. I don't know if there's like piracy in this game. I know there's fishing. I know there's a lot of simple stuff, but I'm excited to see how deep this game is. Oh god, we got a storm system coming in, and the boat's getting a little bit rocky, I'm assuming. Whoa, okay. That's all right. Just take the camera from me. But yes, we're going through the storm. Oh shit, son! Okay, everyone's dead now. Fear not, Spirit Seer. You and your friends are safe. Bullshit, lady. I just saw everything blow up. You will see them again, but first I have a great task ahead of you. This sounds like the Mafia. They're definitely dead, and they just want me to do something for them. I am Airy, once proud protector of these lands. I have been waiting for you. Please, may I see your compass? Yeah, you want to see this thing? All right, you ready? There you go. As I thought, a celestial compass, use it whenever you are lost. I'm lost all the time, lady. It will guide you truly. But for now, your path is blocked. I thought you said this would just guide me truly, but now my path is blocked? My family can help you, but they themselves are lost. Find them and they will lead you home. Now, Sprite Seer, awaken. Your journey has only begun. Okay, here we go, guys. All right, so a little bit of a cutscene telling you about the story. We got a special compass and now We're in a cave. Oh my god, where's my friends? Yeah, we got fucked up. Okay, this thing is crashed in here, so I guess we just gotta get out of this cave here. Is there anything I can do? Nope, I can just hold this lantern like a boss. Totally fine with me. Can I break this? All right, don't give me a crate if I can't break it. That's against the rules. All right, ooh, we got something shiny over here. What's the strange blue glow? I wonder what it is, game. It's Lumi. I actually remember Lumi. This is going to be our little buddy, a human. It's been a long time since I've talked to a human. All of the people who could talk to me have gone away. Please take me with you. I don't want to be alone anymore. And now we got Lumi. Now, I think Lumi gives us tips and whatnot. So that's pretty cool. All right, can we pick? Oh, we can. I think we can pick up these mushrooms. All right, so we got some mushrooms. We can eat those later. Boil them, mash them, stick it. Oh, that's potatoes, not mushrooms. All right. Hi again, Lumi. The way out is just past the murk. It's bad stuff for you humans, though. I'll try to get rid of it, but I am not sure if I can do it alone. Come on, little Lumi. You can do it. You can do it, Lumi, and you did it. I don't know if Lumi's a male or a female. It's hard to tell. I'm gonna say that's definitely a female-looking character. That was hard. I wish I had my brothers and sisters to help me out. If we work together, I think we can find them. Okay, so our quest expands. We gotta find Lumi's family for her. Oh, epic music. Oh my god, I remember this. I remember this view. Ah, beautiful. This game, if anything, is beautiful. That is for darn sure. Okay, so can I actually... All right, there we go. Our journey begins. Oh, there's a village over there. Let's go check it out. I thought you got attacked or something. Jeez, you gotta relax, Lumi. You really aren't looking the best. I bet we can find some help there. Remember, if we get lost, you can use your celestial compass, yada, 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 and we also have a map. Anyways, let's head over to the village. Okay, Lumi. I think, if I remember correctly... Yes. I love this game. I love how adorable and innocent it is. But yes, you Mary Poppins when you jump down any cliff so you don't take fall damage, which is a nice thing, you know? Beefalo, is that you? Can I eat you? I probably shouldn't. I don't know if he's aggressive. He's too adorable to be aggressive. Mind you. Oh. Okay, I'm sorry, buddy. Are you scared of me? Oh, this is freaking adorable. Okay, I'm just gonna... I just want to mount you. Okay, that sounded wrong. I just want to mount and ride you like a horse. Let's just say that. But clearly it's not working. He doesn't even want me to see his front end. Like, I don't know why. Maybe he's self-conscious of his face. Look at him. Okay, so we got to go. All right, this map is actually really easy. We got to go up here. And yeah, I guess we'll figure out what we're doing here and then we'll go maybe try some skills out and whatnot. If a villager has a exclamation mark, that means they want to talk to you. No way, I didn't play MMOs before. Alright, so talk to Master Lo.
Ooh.
Oh, you look like you've been through some hard times. Yeah, my whole fucking pirate ship exploded. Then I met some weird creature in a cave. Please come inside, I can offer you some warm food and a soft bed. If Mervert the pervert taught me anything, it's to not go into an old man's house. But yeah, that sounds good. Let's go, buddy. The townsfolk warmly welcome you. Okay, well that went better than expected. I was expecting the worst. Once your belly is full and your worries are eased, your head hits the soft pillow and you drift to sleep. Oh, this is cool. There. Much better. You look ready to face the world again. Just one more thing before you go. Ever since that terrible accident years ago, Murk has been popping up all over the place, making life difficult. But the people here are friendly and we love to share what we know. Ask around, you'll soon have all the skills you need to make your way in this world. Okay, thank you, old man. All right, Lumi, we have to go meet the townsfolk, I guess. So we'll go see if there's any interesting individuals. 8 stone should be plenty to prop up the east docks back up. So yeah, they're mad at me because I crashed my ship in here and they want me to fix the damn thing. I'm sorry. Everybody died. It was awful. And now you want me to fix it. You'll find stone around the grasslands and near the cliff. Once you got enough, deliver them back to the marina on the bench. Okay, so it looks like we're just going to be picking up a bunch of quests and it's already nighttime. I love how I automatically pull out my lantern. This game, I'm going to say it's definitely catered to a younger audience, but I love how easy it is as well. It's just a very fun game to play so far. All right, these are just trade guys. Well, I'm gonna go get all the quests real quick. All right, this guy's a trader and he wants some vines and sticks and he'll share me a trade secret. I feel like this is a pyramid scheme. I'm getting scammed left, right, and center right now. All right, and you're a small lady. Jesus Christ. Minnie. Okay, good name for you, Minnie. I hear you're in need of a roof over your head. Well, you're in luck. The old farm in the south field was abandoned where the murk appeared. Okay, murk is a big issue in this place, by the way. If you can clear the murk, you're welcome to the farm. I'd love to see the old place patched up and running again. So there's housing, that's cool. Take this axe and gather some materials to fix the place up. Alright, so we need wood, stone, so basically we can go explore now, get some materials, and do these quests. Alright, so the biggest thing I want, I think, is to get this home. I want to see what the homes are all about, so we're gonna go out. Actually, I can probably... Can I just chop? I'm thinking about axing. I don't know how to axe just yet, though. Hold on. Ah, it's Q or E. That's confusing. Okay, so we can axe anything. What? Okay, old man in a field at the middle of the night. This is weird as well. What do you have? Okay, what do you have down there? Like, he's just weird, really weird looking. Sly McWiley. Oh, that's why. Okay, this is Sly McWiley. So you're the traveler who washed ashore earlier, eh? Well, no wonder you look a little wimpy to me. Hey, dude, shut the fuck up. You're sitting in a field alone. It's weird. It's important to be strong and healthy. You have to be big muscles like me to cut fodder all day. Yeah, you really look jacked, buddy. You really look jacked. Here, take this sickle and show me what you've got. Cut along the grass and bring me 10 times fodder. Okay. Pop these details into your... Enter? What? Okay, journal. Okay, so it's telling me the journal button, in case you forget. Okay, thanks, Sly McWiley, you weird bastard. Okay, so we can probably just do this here. Oh, yeah, that is... Oh, that is very pleasing. And it auto-picks up, you just gotta go above it. Alright, Sly McWiley, that took me a grand total of 2 seconds. There you go, buddy. That long grass didn't stand a chance! You're not as wimpy as I thought. Thanks, buddy. All right, good morning to day two, ladies and gentlemen. This is just freaking beautiful. You can see the world's actually very big and very beautiful. So right now we're just kind of just wandering about, doing these quests slowly. Oh, I could pick whatever that thing up was up. Oh, it's a flower. So we're gonna pick that up. There we go. Now we need to find rocks. Now I know these look like rocks, but it's not letting me mine them. So I guess I'll just follow the quest and we'll go see where it leads me. This looks like a mineable rock, I gotta assume. Just one hanging out in the middle here. Ooh, there's actually a cave as well. But yes, we got some rock now, so let's pick up those. I think we need 10. Now, it said my farmhouse is through the cave, so I'm assuming this is the farmhouse I will be getting somewhere around... Well, there's nothing really down here, so maybe it was a different cave. All right, we need some wood. I'm slowly finding boulders that I can mine. I'm assuming I can hit, yeah, pretty much any tree. Now, do they fall? That's the question. I'm so sorry, little raccoon. I didn't even see you there. Is that a cat? What are you? Oh, you have discovered spotted brown cat. I thought it was a raccoon, and I just cut his house down. I felt so bad for a second there. Okay, pick up that. There we go. I don't know why it didn't pick up this one, but it picked up all the other ones. Okay, I got the sickle for some reason. Oh, that's because I pressed E. So I'm gonna have to get used to these button schemes. But this is cool. I love the gathering in this game. Very easy to do. Very rewarding. It's not boring and monotonous like most survival games. But for some reason, I actually gotta pick these up. Is that a treasure chest? Yes, it is. I found red shampoo. That's gotta be the last color of shampoo you want. You're just gonna look like a bloody mess by the end of it. All right, but I did some collecting. I think I got everything I need now for the quest that I currently have. So we're gonna go back up. Let's actually get this rock, since rocks seem to be pretty hard to find. And I'm assuming we're gonna need boulders to build our house and whatnot. But yeah, we're gonna finish up, repair the farm, and then we should hopefully get that farm. All right. We got some murkiness over here. Now, can she come out and help me? I thought we could get rid of it. Now, oh, yeah, F to clear murk. There we go. To purify the murk, you must use sprites. You have found... Okay, so we still need to find one more before we can do it, unfortunately. She needs her brother or sister's help, so I don't even know where to look for those. I'm assuming they're just kind of randomly about. Is that an animal? Oh god, it moves! Okay, I thought it was a fucking rock! Okay, it said I discovered a fabbit, so this is... Why does everybody not want to look at me? I just want to see your adorable freaking face, and you're just running away from me. I can't even... I don't have something to attack you. But yeah, it looks like it almost looks like a rabbit ate a Kirby, and that's what popped out pretty much. So yeah, we found the second animal. What I have to find, though, is sprites. All right, I've spent one full day looking for this damn sprite, and, yeah, it's nowhere to be found, so actually, I changed the quest accidentally. Let's go back, and let's go at least put in any quest that we've finished. So, let's head over to Grass Needs Cutting, which is, we can actually see the guy from over here. That's a really cool mechanic. I love this compass, especially if you're very confused in games like this. It just makes life so much easier. If you've never played something like an RPG, or an MMO for that matter, at least now you know. Okay, so I think, do we have to talk to Master Lo? After you've settled in, come back and see me. No, so it's somewhere in here, though. Hey, buddy, I got the quest for you, Hugh. Uh-huh. All right, so those things I got you to grab aren't actually for me. They're for you. Oh, as well as making trade deals, you can craft items to trade. Crafted items generally trade for a higher price, which is nice. Here's a recipe to craft a bundle of sticks. You mean a fag game? I mean, I understand this is for kids, but that's what a fag is, a bundle of sticks. When those items you grabbed, just remember you need a recipe and the correct items to craft. Okay, so quest complete, making a bundle. Great. Make it a bundle of fags right here.
I thought, what? Huh? That bush moved. What is this thing?
Oh my god, you are a camoed bush. Okay, give item? What am I supposed to give it? The sprig pig seems interested in your mushroom. Give the mushroom to the sprig pig. Yeah, sprig pig, I'll give you that. Please follow me. Oh, it follows me. This game, adorable. I fucking love it. Now, I wonder if I can get rid of this. This looks like a smaller version. I need three for this one. That's even worse. So you need a certain amount for every merc. All right, Sprig Pig, so I found another friend here, and he's, I don't know what he does. Can I talk to him? He just wants more items. You know what, Sprig Pig, screw you, buddy. All right, but right now I'm looking for vines, because I want to build this bridge. I'm thinking maybe there's a sprite if we can get across the gap to build a bridge. Ooh, this isn't creepy. Finding all these different flowers now. We got different tree forms, so yeah, I'm getting into a different part of the map, I think. Let's actually open the map and see. Yes, we're leaving the grasslands, and we went into the Dapplewood Forest. So I definitely want to go back to the grasslands, because that's where my quests are. Oh, is this? I think this is a fishing competition. Talk to the fisherman. This is here is a fishing competition. To enter, you need to find yourself a fishing pole. Come back once you got one. I really want to do some fishing, too, because what I remember, that was really fun. Now, I see this blue thing over here. I'm hoping it's a sprite, so I'm heading over there. All right, please be a sprite. Oh, it looks like this head. This head looks like a head. Oh, sorry, this rock looks like a head. What's that strange blue glow? What is that strange? Can I not get up there? We got something on the wall here. Can I actually... Let's see if I can mine this. Okay, no, there's some sort of crystal here. I think I need a pickaxe to get into here. I can't break it. Unless I need to do... I do need to do something, I think. Spin... Oh, it's a puzzle. So I think... I didn't even notice these guys over here because it's so dark. I think we need to get these to look at them. So we want this guy to spin right. Okay, that was the wrong way. My bad. That is spinning left, correct? And I'm telling it to spin right. So whatever. It doesn't matter. Just got to spin that one. And then bam. There we go. Oh, please tell me this is the sprite. This is so freaking cool. Should I go into his mouth? What's that strange blue glow? I'm curious. Okay, F to interact. Yes! We got the second one. I think that was a real turning point in our relationship. Oh yeah, cub. I haven't even met you before, you little jerk, but I saved you. So it's you and me traveling buddies. And what's her name as well? Can't forget about her. So that's good. We got almost all the vines we need for that bridge. We already found the sprite, so we don't even technically need the vines anymore. But we may as well do both of the quests. And yeah, we might finally get our farmland. So let's actually, what do we got right now? Repair the bridge. So we'll just do that first, and then we'll go back and get, hopefully, our home. There we go. We got our final vine right there. I just want to say I love this too. When you use your umbrella, the light is attached to your umbrella. Beautiful idea. This game is just... Oh, I shouldn't have went down here. Actually, there's a cave. We're okay. But we actually got to build a bridge right across this cave. If you can see those two rock faces, that's exactly where we're going. So I don't know what's over there. We're going to find out in a second though. And then I believe this is our farmland right over here, too. So this is going to work out well, the right side by side. But yeah, let's try this out. So complete this quest and build the bridge. F to interact. There we go. We will accept that. Look at that. Just like that. Don't need a worker crew or anything. It's fucking magic, bitches. And we got our bridge built. So that feels... I feel like I'm progressing. That feels pretty good. Is there... Okay, this is not able to be, traversed except with that bridge, so there's gotta be something good up here, right? I didn't do this for nothing. I'm gonna get dizzy here. If anything, I did it for the view. This is freaking beautiful. And we can actually break these boxes with my mallet. I love how he spins it. He winds it up. We also got a chest here, so that alone is worth it. And we got some currency in that chest. And there's a little bug. All right, well, I was hoping for more, gotta be honest, but I'm happy with that. Oh, we got foxes over here. Hey, little foxes. Grass fox. You guys, oh, you're actually looking at me, too. Look at you. Oh, you guys are confident motherfuckers. Give item? I don't think I want to give any more things items. By the way, that pig, he fucked off after I wouldn't give him anymore. All right, we just need a little bit more wood for the farm now. I used all the wood building that bridge, so thankfully getting wood in this game is really quick, and that should be good. Clear the mark, so we just got to go and do that, so I guess we'll head towards the quest. So there's the quest right there. I'm assuming it's this merc right here. We will clear that. We got all the sprites we need. And there we go. Let's get rid of that little sprites. Bam! Just like that. Magic. Once again. Now we probably got to repair this, don't we? And it looks like it's going to take a while. All right, Bushel. Here you go, buddy. Oh, hey there. I'm Bushel. Minnie sent me to help you out. Oh, thanks, Bushel. I'm a dab hand at repairs, and I know a thing or two about running a farm. Now you've cleared the murk, let's roll up our sleeves and patch this place up. I don't think it's technically patching. This thing is fucking broken down, dude. Like, it's not just gonna be a couple boards and hammered to the side of the wall, because we don't even got freaking walls. But, yeah, there we go. We got the Southfield farm. It's got a low rating right now. There's no animal care. Cleanliness is good. We got something going for us. You now have your very own farm. There are lots of things you can do with a farm. Here, I'll give you some farm items. Let's get you started by placing a large animal pen. Yes, I want to get some of those piggies. Once you've crafted the large animal pen, you can use your big book on your farm to place the pen wherever you like. So you can totally customize too. Oh, this is cool, guys. Like, I don't know what I thought going into this. I thought it was beautiful, but I didn't know too much about the game, so I am really happy with that. We got... Oh, shit, Grumble! What's up, dude? Hey, kid, I had a perfectly good thing going on here, and you came along and ruined it. I'm sorry, Grumble. I guess there's no going back to that pigsty now. So let's get a move on, youngster. Okay, so we got an old sprite now. It's Captain Pullen again! I found him on the beach! I heard you wandered into Fairmount. I'm glad to see you are doing well, considering I wanted to come and say hello. But Marina has kept me busy gathering the materials to fix the docks. She said I owe her, since it was my boat that wrecked it. Well, I had to get her some too, didn't I? Well, I'm here helping Mary out. Could you try to dig up information on the rest of the crew? Yeah, I was told they're fine, but I don't believe it, dude. All right, so I'm just waiting out the night because I didn't want to build my farm during darkness. It's a little disorienting, so I figured that we would just gather some stuff. And yeah, explore, see what else we can find. We found the captain again, at least. Oh, is he asleep? He's fucking sleeping, guys. Oh, I can see you. You're so cute. Oh, I'm sorry. I woke you up. That's so cool. So they sleep at night. I wish I could put my lantern away and go right up to them. But yeah, they sleep at night. Oh, the animals in this game are great. So it should be close to daytime now. So I think we're just going to set this up. So I think we got to go over to the book here. And, ooh, okay. Space to build. I'll try that. And they wanted a large animal pen. What else do we got? Fodder trow, water trow, then large and small animal pen. So we are going to do that. And, oh, so we just got to... Oh, cool. Look at this. So I'm going to try and put as much here as possible. So I don't know which the front, what's the back. Okay, so that is definitely the front. All right, and we'll rotate that just like... Actually, should we do it? I think I like the idea of doing it sideways like that. So we're going to put that there. Oh, building. So easy. So great. And now we got an animal pen. Now, I'm going to be honest, I thought it would be an actual pen, but it looks like they can roam free, so that's pretty cool. Large animal pen, empty. So how do I... Okay, I guess I got to go talk to my buddy. I think he asked me to talk to him after I was done that. So how do we get said animals now? Do I have to go wrestle them? Well done. Now that you've placed a large animal pen, you can begin to adopt large animals. Oh, so that's why you feed them. When you're ready, come see me again, and I'll teach you how to do that. I want to do that right now, dude. Let's get some animals today. So we're going to go talk to Bushel again. Groffles are the best. They are those big brown grazing animals. I agree. I wanted those anyways. You'll find them in the fields near here. Yes, I know that. Besides being big and fluffy, if domesticated, they'll produce groff milk. Ew. Gross. Okay, now they're immediately gross, thinking they're drinking that shit. No wonder why this guy looks high as hell. There's something in that for sure. You can befriend animals by feeding them their favorite food. Feed Groff psyllium seed, and it will be happy to follow you for a time. Here, I'll show you how to get psyllium seed, and you can go out there and bring us back a big fluffy groffle. Okay, are you gonna tell me? New recipe, psyllium seeds. Okay, so what do? Begin a farmhand. I guess we can just go get them now. Craft a psyllium seed. Okay, so I still don't know how to craft, so I gotta figure that out. All right, I think, yes, there we go. So now I got into my inventory. We haven't even been in here yet. Look at, I think I had a different, look at that. I got a better shirt in here and shit. Where did I get this stuff? Look at my friggin', I am like ghetto booty for days. Like seriously, check out that thing. All right, unfortunately, we can change hair. So can I actually go bald? Looks like I can't actually empty the slot, so, we can, shit, I didn't mean to double click and use it. Well, I guess we got red hair now, so that's what the red shampoo does, that's cool. Oh, it's in here, so now, okay, so this is the crafting menu, the scissors, getting the hang of it now. So we want to do a couple of these at least. Looks like that's all we can do for right now, but we got three, that means we can get three of these little bastards, or at least we can feed them, and it, hopefully it follows us long enough. So come here, buddy, I got some delicious seeds. Ooh, he's actually still looking at me, so he seems actually interested. Oh my god, that's so cool. So now that he knows he has something, or I have something that he wants, he's totally fine with me being here. So, seem interested in psyllium seeds? Yeah, dude, come on, let's go, and I'm gonna milk you for some fucking reason. That's weird as shit to think about. All right, come on, milk can. I'm gonna call you that from now on, because that's exactly what you are. What the fuck are you looking at? He's just looking at the rocks. He's an interesting one. All right, dude. I got this big fluffy beast. What do you want me to do with him? Should I ask you or should I just go? Growl. What? That's what groffles say when they're hungry or sleepy or happy or anything. Okay, thanks, buddy. All right, come on, buddy. Let's go because he didn't help me out. I thought you said you were a farmer and you knew all this shit and he's just making me do everything. So, yeah, I'm assuming, do you wish to adopt the groffle? Yes. I would love to adopt the groffle. Can I name it? Oh. Wow, now that's a fluffy groffle. Thanks, man. Oh. We can now make groffle milk, so check from time to time to collect the goods we're producing. Oh. I'll be here to look after any animals you adopt, but it's a good idea to put in some food and water to keep it happy. What happens if I don't? Do you kill it? Like, it's a good idea, but you don't have to do it, is basically what he's saying. Don't forget, if you want to build your farm more, you'll need the help of a carpenter. I would love to do that. Farming sounds really fun in this game. So we got a groffle now. Is he actually? Oh, he's in there. Hey, buddy. Hey, milk can, how you doing? Go on a journey. Care for. Okay, I'm gonna care for. There you go, buddy. Yeah, I love you, you little milk-producing bastard. All right, guys. Well, I think that's a good time to wrap up this one. I gotta say, I am so impressed with this game. I thought it would just be a one-off, but I'm thinking about doing a little mini-series on it. I know we got so many series going on, though, so let me know in the comments below what you guys think of this. Do you want to see some more or not? And yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. As always, guys, thanks for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.